Empty stadiums often have an atmosphere of expectation about them. They need the roar of a crowd to bring them alive. And Moscow's Luzhniki Stadium, fresh from a complete refit, is waiting for the biggest footballing spectacle of them all.
The reconstruction took about 3 years. The entire core of it had to be demolished except for the external walls. The stadium is a high-technology facility. The pitch has natural grass with a special ventilation and a heating system, and there are more than 65 kilometers of engineering tubes under it.
The readiness of Russia's 12 World Cup stadiums is facing the usual pre-competition scrutiny. Yekaterinburg's temporary stands raised concerns a few months ago. FIFA assures us everything will be fine.
Altogether, there'll be 7 matches played here at Luzhniki, including the opening match, the semi-final and the final itself. Together with the Olympics, the World Cup is one of the 2 biggest sporting events in the world, which makes it not just about football, but about politics too.
The glory of Russia's last big sporting bonanza barely lasted beyond the closing ceremony. 2014's Winter Olympics in Sochi were tarnished first by Russia's military involvement in Ukraine and then a widespread doping scandal. So providing everything goes well this summer, the World Cup is an opportunity to mend Russia's reputation somewhat. And it happens to be a presidential election year too.
Sports is extremely, tremendously important for Russian politics and for Russia as a empire of military force, empire of, to lesser extent, economic force, political force. Sports means kind of a warfare for these elites.
National pride matters hugely in Russia, particularly with many people left poorer by the recent recession. In a wintry central Moscow, they dare to hope.
Of course we believe in our football team.
We believe in our victory.
We will aim for the finals. We are supporting them. We believe in them. This is our Russia.
Summer can't come soon enough. Rory Challands, Al Jazeera, Moscow.